What's going on, dudes? My name is Prestige. Thank you so much for joining me on the channel. This is episode number 33 of a series that I like to call Elite Weapons of Advanced Warfare. In this series, we're going to be taking a look at elite variations of weapons you'll earn in your supply drops while playing through Call of Duty Advanced Warfare. I'll let you know whether or not those weapons are worth keeping or scrapping for the 2000 XP. If you happen to miss any of the other 32 episodes, I'll make sure to have a complete playlist linked down below in the description and in the form of a card, which you find on your screen right now. But without further ado, let us get into this Beast mode gameplay right here in the beginning. I'm not sure what happened with this thing. I was just like trapped in a corner and people started coming left and right, quite literally, and the Damnation definitely saved me there. This is, of course, the ARX-160 Damnation, and I have a few things that I would like to say about it. The first thing that I would like to say is this weapon isn't deserving of the Elite title. To be completely honest with you, I think the only reason it has the Elite title is the design that it has, the weapon camouflage, the look of it. It's different than any other weapon in the game. Obviously, it is going to be deserving of the Elite title, but those statistics don't really reflect that. And to be completely honest with you, the other variants that I would always recommend, hands down, the hole puncher if you have it. It's the best ARX you can possibly get. And then we have the ARX-160 Steel Bite, which is the other Elite variant. It brings up your damage by 3 and your fire rate is down by 1, but the same thing's happening pretty much with the Damnation, except you don't have that increased damage, and it is going to take you multiple bursts to get one kill unless all three rounds land on the headshot. And that's another thing that I want to talk about too. Going into the statistics right now, we have three things that are bad with this weapon. Two things that are good with this weapon. The three things that are bad, the first thing is the handling's decreased by 1, which means your hip fire spread is going to be increased, and that's bad. You don't want a wide hip fire spread. You want that as tight as possible, but you're not really going to notice that too much. This is a precision weapon. It's a 3-round burst weapon. I highly recommend using it at a range, especially since this does have the best in class range, and you're going to want to try to keep yourself a distance from the enemy, especially with this Damnation, because it's going to take you multiple bursts, and we'll talk about that in just a moment. The fire rate is decreased. I don't understand why, considering this weapon has a decreased damage. I personally believe that this fire rate should have remained normal or not messed with, or positive, like a positive 1, so it had a better, faster fire rate. Reason being, you will never be able to get a one-shot kill or one-burst kill with this weapon. It's always going to take 2 bursts unless you hit all 3 rounds directly on their head. That is when you can get a one-burst kill, but otherwise, if the enemy has 100% health and you're shooting them in the upper body, even in the neck, you're not going to be able to get a one-burst kill. It's going to take you 4 to 5 rounds every single time, which is ridiculous. You don't want that when using a precision weapon like that. You want to be able to get that one-burst kill, and that's exactly what the professional hole puncher and the other elite weapon, the Steel Bite, are able to provide for you, is one burst kills in core game modes. That's something that you're going to want, especially with the precision weapon. Now, moving on to the good, we have a range increase. This is not going to help you whatsoever. It's still going to take you 2 bursts to kill somebody in the body, and if you get the headshot, it goes out a little bit of a range, so you're still able to get a one burst headshot from really far distances, but it just doesn't reflect because that damage is down. Now, the one good that this weapon has is an accuracy increase. So this is basically going to give you a free foregrip, and the weapon itself, since it is precision and 3-round burst, you definitely don't have to use a foregrip at all with this weapon, so that's just like an added benefit. If you wanted to use the foregrip and have even pinpoint laser accuracy, you can do that, but you're already going to have that here with the Damnation. The gameplay you're watching really reflects that, because I'm using the target enhancer, which is something that I never use, and I wanted to try it out with the quick draw handle in the stock, so that's exactly what I did in this gameplay. The quick draw handle is just to help me aim down sight a little bit faster. You're definitely going to want to use that with this assault rifle, and the accuracy is still amazing. I didn't need to use a foregrip, and I didn't have to worry too much about it, but the ARX-160 Damnation is just one of those weapons where I would say, if you're not a fan of using precision weapons, if you need to rank up and you need 2000 XP, and if you're not collecting all of the elite weapons, go ahead, scrap this thing out for some XP, and get yourself some more supply drops, and look for a different variation. Use the hole puncher, use the Steel Bite. The Damnation really isn't that good of an elite weapon. The only thing I can say that it has going for it is a really cool paint job, and you know, the camouflage pattern itself just looks really different. The weapon overall design is just great. It has the long barrel on there, but that doesn't really reflect the damage that it can do in game, which is unfortunate. So I hope you all enjoyed this video. If you did, make sure to click that thumbs up button down below, and do not forget to subscribe for more awesome videos each and every day. Until next time, everybody, I am out. Peace.